Good morning! Guess what I'm doing? I'm editing the video from Diagon Alley! This is the snake speaking parcel tongue.
You can't really tell in the video though because there's a lot of noise in the expansion just with the crowds and the background noises, so
unfortunately that was a really cool part that you didn't really get to hear. But on a side note, there was a wasp, a huge wasp, right behind my little mannequin lady, and I texted the neighbor and I said, hey, do you have any wasp spray?
And she saved the day because she did have wasp spray, and there was a huge wasp while I was trying to edit this video.
And now it's dead. It's back there somewhere. I'll find it.
But literally, our neighbors are the best.
All right, it's finally exporting. It is 2.5 hour export. It's 1:30 now.
So that's a long one. Hope you guys are not getting sick of all of the Harry Potter vlogs. We just love it so much, and we want to show you guys, because a lot of you guys aren't able to see it right away, and I really think you should come and see it. It's incredible. It's incredible. And I know some people had made comments that they were very sad that Jaws was gone and that Potter was there now, and to be honest with you, I felt the same way. I even wore my Jaws shirt yesterday because I miss Jaws as well, but being inside of Diagon Alley, Nocturne Alley, London, the London area, I mean, it's so immersive that I don't know. I love it too much. And I'm not like a huge Harry Potter fan. I've only seen the movies once. I've never read the books. But now I'm kind of inclined to do that. I think it's gonna just create a new generation of Harry Potter fans. These little kids that are in there doing their spells, and I can just see them like wanting to buy the books and the movies. And I think that's so cute. I love it, I love it.
Okay, so it's like 2 o'clock in the afternoon and it's time for breakfast. I've been working all morning. Little Bandit has been very curious as to what I have been doing because I've been spending a lot more time than normal editing. But there's my breakfast. Yay, breakfast time. Yay, yay. I put one of the dog beds in the kitchen because I spend a lot of time in here, and I think it was the best idea I've ever had. Look how cute you are just laying in the kitchen with me.
He's like so mad that I'm interrupting his nap time.
But you're just so cute. I'm sorry. I had to interrupt for just 1 minute. Look at that little puppy foot. Oh.
I was just getting the mail from last week kind of organized because I'm crazy.
I'm sorry it's raining. It's gonna rain pretty bad tonight. I'm sorry we haven't done a mail vlog in a while. We have just been so super busy
and we've gotten so much stuff that I might break it up into a two-parter.
Yeah, we got our annual pass holder's passport in the mail and it tells them all kinds of fun stuff like what's new at Universal, City Walk, Hot Dog Hall of Fame, Vivo Italian Kitchen, a new Universal store, Cowfish, Bread Box, and Menchie's. Which, Breadbox and Menchie's are already opened. Cowfish should be opening soon. What else? Cabana Bay is now open. Ooh, Wizarding World of Harry Potter, Diagon Alley. You guys got blackouts if you're a Power Pass holder. Rock the Universe coming up. Halloween Horror Nights coming up. Aqua Drag Racer at Wet n Wild. All kinds of fun stuff. And then there's this whole thing about Diagon Alley here. Ooh, yeah, look at that. We already did it. No, we didn't do it. Darn it. Soon. We saw the dragon. What else is in here? Ooh. What is this thing? Oh, these are the different things that you can buy in here. I don't know why they don't have an actual picture of the place. Why do they just have a concept rendering of Leaky Cauldron and this one and the ice cream parlor? Oh yeah, the ice cream parlor was so good. Yeah, so here's a quick rundown of what's in here. Inside of Diagon Alley is Escape from Gringotts, Weasley's Wizard Wheezes, Ollivanders, we've got Madame Malkin's Robes, The Magical Menagerie, Wiseacre's Wizarding Equipment, Quality Quidditch Supplies, The Leaky Cauldron, Florine Fortescue's Ice Cream Parlor, and then we open it up. Oh, and what do they have? They have a nice map in here for us. Wow. Oh, this is a cool map. This is really cool. So you see the Forbidden Journey here. Hippogriff, this is all over at Islands, right? In Hogsmeade. And they make it look like old-timey type thing. So you got Honeydukes, the Three Broomsticks, there's the lake. Over here is Jurassic Park. This is Forbidden Journey, Flight of the Hippogriff. Hagrid's Hut, which you can't get to, it's just in Flight of the Hippogriff. Dragon Challenge, and then you've got the Hogsmeade Station now that has the train that goes over and pops out at King's Cross. Yeah, over here. And right around the corner from King's Cross, you can go into Diagon Alley. And you got Weasley's Wizard Wheezes, The Leaky Cauldron, Diagon Alley, Ollivanders, Escape from Gringotts, Nocturne Alley, all kinds of fun stuff. This is awesome. London, here's the bus out here and everything. This is the waterfront. Simpsons is like yonder. This is awesome. And the Amity is right here. Oh. You know, I always did wonder what the scale of magical fun was. And then they also have the Hogwarts Express. And then here's the big news right here. It's the moment the Harry Potter fans and annual pass holders have been waiting for. Check our email. That's what we have to do. So, yeah. That's right, folks. We've put it off long enough. We gotta do a mail vlog, so stay tuned for that. We'll probably have to split it up into two different mail vlogs because this was one trip to the mailbox and this was another, but we didn't have time to film this one because of all the Harry Potter stuff going on. So we're gonna film them both today and see what we got. So here's what's going down. We are worn out from going, like me, working full 8 hours, then going to Universal and then getting home at midnight and waking up at 4 the next day, 2 days in a row. So we're gonna stay home tonight, and I think we're gonna start watching the Harry Potters, because, I mean, you gotta do that, right? And besides that, it's not looking too fantastic out. So I have a feeling tonight's gonna be the night that it actually does rain at Universal, whereas, like, there's some thunder. The last two nights, it looked like it was gonna rain, and then it didn't actually rain. So I think we're better off staying home. I mean, it's not the Leaky Cauldron, but gosh darn, that looks good. Sorry, Bandit, I know it's thundering, and you're, like, super scared now, but that's Florida, right? Hey, you okay? Yes, it's raining. It's a good thing we didn't go down to Universal. Yeah, that wouldn't have been fun. But hey, our grill's getting clean now. Yeah, look at that thing, so pretty. I probably should have left it on for that thunder, right? Sorry, it'll happen again, right? Now. I ran out there and opened it up to maybe get some more cleaning on the inside. Rain, nature's grill wash. Thunder will happen soon, I swear. Come on. Oh, it's starting to rain harder. No? All right. I want you guys to remind me, next time I go to Universal, I gotta bring this monopod because it will make it so much easier to film stuff. I can get way cool angles, like way up high and stuff like that. Just like, I don't know, I've had it and I've never once used it. Gotta start using it. I'm gonna use it today for the mail vlog because holding my arm out like this hurts real bad because I've been doing it for a day and a half now, or 2 days, because of the Universal stuff and how long those videos were. My arm's starting to hurt up here in my shoulder, so we got the monopod. Oh, that's nice. Look, you guys can it's kind of fun, right? Let's see how long you guys can balance for, all right? You guys work really hard, try in your mind to balance, okay? You ready? Pretty good, pretty good. Let's give it one more try. You guys ready? Okay, here we go. Oh, all right. I think it'd be kind of fun to walk around Universal like this, Yeah, I think people might get angry at me. This thing's sticking out 6 feet from me. This really hurts my arm. Right?
Bandit has been very sad today because of all this rain. We're just sitting here doing the mail vlog and we have lots more to go through. We have so much mail. We will never ever let it get this backed up again, I promise. But yay, okay, back to the mail vlog.
All right, this is where it gets good. You guys ready? This is an original map of Universal. So you'd walk in through the main entrance, you got Hitchcock's 3Ds, The Fantastic World of Hanna-Barbera, which this is now Shrek, and that's now Jimmy Neutron, this is, what is it now?
Despicable Me.
And then you got Murder, She Wrote Mystery Theater, Rocky, The Adventures of Rocky and Bullwinkle, which is now,
Transformers.
Where Transforms is.
Is it? No, it isn't.
This is, and also, the Monster Cafe, that's what this is now.
Oh, okay.
Monster's Cafe, and Transformers is also over here. The Boneyard, which is now where the amphitheater is. Ghostbusters, which is where Twister is now.
I didn't know there was a Ghostbusters ride.
Confrontation, which is now the Mummy. And then we've got all these restaurants and stuff. Beetlejuice's Graveyard is still there. Earthquake, the big one, is now Disaster. Dynamite Night's Stunt Spectacular was like a boat show that they did in the lake. Wild Wild West Stunt Show, which is now Fear Factor. Amity Avenue, which I guess they didn't have Jaws back then, but Amity's still there, which is awesome. Back to the Future, which is Simpsons now. Animal Actors is still there. Fievel's Playland is still there. E.T. is still there. And the Hard Rock Cafe used to be way back here.
Oh, yeah.
Back behind E.T., and it was shaped like a guitar, and it had a Cadillac shooting out of the front.
That's Barney, right?
Yeah, now Barney's back there, and it's way gone. This is awesome. Oh! Yeah, the Bates Motel.
Oh, yeah.
Right? That was back here somewhere. Because they did the backstage lot tour right there.
Yeah.
That's awesome. And look, the globe is totally different now.
Oh yeah, look at that.
This is awesome. And here's the old Hard Rock Cafe.
That is so crazy.
Right?
I've never even seen the original map. That's awesome.
So in the mail vlog, somebody sent us little bags of blue sky, and I just realized because I got up to go to the bathroom and take a break for a second, this could be actual meth and we would never know. Like, what if somebody just sent us meth in the mail and was like, yeah, this is a movie prop. We don't know.
Somebody sent us astronaut ice cream. And it's
delicious. I can't remember the last time I had astronaut ice cream. You know what it's like? Lucky Charms marshmallows.
Oh yeah, this is vanilla and strawberry. It's so good. I love astronaut ice cream.
That is really good.
This is like, we had it whenever, every time we went to the Space Center, I was like, Mom, can I have some astronaut ice cream? She's like, no, it's expensive. And I'm like, no, I loved it that one time.
I want some more. Eating all the ice cream.
Yeah, it's delicious. I'm gonna eat it all, Jen.
No, 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 some's for me. Was it only addressed to you?
Yep.
You lie. Oh, he's a liar. This is the coolest thing. It is the tiniest letter and a 10 times magnifying glass. Like, and that even has a thing on it too.
That's pretty awesome.
This is so crazy.
This is awesome.
This is like the coolest thing.
I can't even get into this thing.
This is a pretzel pool float. How cool is that? This is so cool. I love this. I'm so excited. Thank you. I love that. That is so cool.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, we're gonna have so many pool floats. This is gonna be amazing. Yes.
And we can inflate it now.
I know. Oh my gosh. This is so crazy. Wow.
This is so great.
Check these out, you guys.
She taught herself to crochet 4 years ago by watching videos on YouTube.
This is so cute.
We just filmed I filled up an entire memory card, 32 gigs. That's a lot of video. And that was just two mail vlogs. That's it. Pretty crazy. We got so much stuff. Thank you guys for sending us so much stuff. You guys are amazing.
We got a couple of rocks in the mail vlog that I've got to take out and put in the rock garden, but it's dark out, so hopefully you guys will still be able to see it. There they are. It's also raining kind of a lot still out here. But yeah, getting put in the rock garden. Nice.
So here's the question for you guys. I started reading 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea by Jules Verne. It was written in like mid-1800s. Something that they say in the book is portmanteau, which I had to look up what that was, which I'm totally glad that I did because I like to learn new things, but why don't we have portmanteaus anymore? In case you guys are wondering, it's one of those, it's like a traveling wardrobe. It's like a suitcase that's divided into two halves and you set it on the ground and you open it up like a book almost. There's one in the lobby of the Lowe's Royal Pacific that you put your key cards into for like early drop-off or whatever, or early checkout. We got an electric air pump and a bunch of pool toys that I'm gonna inflate now, and it's gonna be awesome!
First thing that we gotta inflate is a party banana. All right.
It worked, go bananas!
Yes.
Let's inflate the watermelon.
Yes, it's alive!
Woo. Oh, that's a good looking pool float.
This is the last one. I think this one will inflate quickly. It's a giant pretzel.
That is a good looking giant pretzel. All right, I'm hoping to get to bed a little bit earlier tonight. It's like 10:21, so that's a little bit earlier than midnight, right? So I'm still gonna get up at 4 a.m. But I will see you guys tomorrow. Now it's time to pay the price. We didn't watch Harry Potter tonight. Maybe tomorrow.